the Emperor Michael Palaiologos contracted the ill-famed Union of Lyon with the Pope to receive his help against the Bulgars and Serbs. The monks of the Holy Mountain sent the Emperor a protest against this union and urged him to set it aside and return to Orthodoxy. During these very trying times for the Holy Mountain, there lived a monk who resided near the Zagrafo monastery and would try ascetically on his own with great labors and effort. This monk had this holy custom of reading the Akathis hymn many times while praying in front of this icon of the Mother of God. One day, while he was chanting, "Rejoice, O unwedded bride," he hears the following words from the icon: "Rejoice too, O elder of God." The elder was frightened, but the voice continued calmly, "Do not fear, but rush to the monastery and announce to the brothers and the abbot that the enemies of myself and of my son have drawn near. Thus, whoever is weak in the spirit, let them hide in patience. The ones desiring a martyr's crown, let them stay inside the monastery. Leave quickly." The Pope sent an army to the Emperor's aid, and this Latin army went onto the Holy Mountain and set about such barbarism as the Turks never perpetrated in 500 years, hanging members of the council and slaughtering many of the monks of Vatopedi, Iveron, and other monasteries. The Latins attacked Zagrafo. The blessed Abbot Thomas told the brethren by inspiration that those who desired to save themselves from the Latins should flee the monastery, and those who desired a martyr's death should stay. 26 men stayed, 22 monks with their abbot, and 4 laymen who worked for the monastery. They all shut themselves in the monastery tower. When the Latins arrived, they set the tower alight, and these 26 heroes found a martyr's death in flames. While the tower was burning, they sang hymns of the Akathist to the Mother of God and gave their holy souls into God's hands on October 10th, 1282. In December of the same year, the dishonorable Emperor Michael Palaiologos died in poverty, the Serbian king Meletios having risen up against him in defense of Orthodoxy.
Hello, I want to share with you something about St. Meletios, the confessor of Mount Galesion, 13th century. He died in 1286. He's commemorated by the Orthodox Church on January 19th. I'm going to read part of page 200, from the book The Departure of the Soul According to the Teaching of the Orthodox Church. It says, "Christ the Lord appeared to him in glory, commanding him to go to Constantinople to defend the Orthodox faith, which was in danger from compromises with the Latins that Emperor Michael VIII had made for political reasons. Presenting himself at the imperial court, St. Meletios boldly reproached the emperor for betraying the faith. Thrown into prison, he was then exiled to the island of Skaros, where he authored a long poem excerpted here, in which he desired to set forth all the essentials of the Orthodox faith in a single gathering. Sent to the Pope in Rome for trial, St. Meletios continued to boldly confess the Orthodox faith, confronting the Latin scholastic theologians and rebuking their errors. Imprisoned for 7 more years, he was then sent back to Skaros and shut up in a dark dungeon. The people's proclamation of the saint as a confessor of the Orthodox faith stirred the emperor to summon him back to the imperial court. Steadfast as ever in proclaiming Orthodoxy, the saint was condemned to torture. He was hung on a dry tree, which burst into leaf upon receiving him. His tongue, which had so bravely spoken the truth, was cut out, but miraculously he was able to continue proclaiming the true faith. Finally, released from imprisonment on the death of Michael VIII, St. Meletios played an important role in reestablishing Orthodoxy. When he departed from this world to God, His face shone like the sun. His body remained incorrupt, becoming a wellspring of countless miracles." End quote. So we see here that the Lord Jesus appeared to St. Meletios. The Lord Jesus endorses Orthodoxy. He does not endorse Roman Catholicism. Hello, I'm going to give an argument on why the holy fire of Jerusalem, which occurs at the Church of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem each year, supports Orthodox Christianity, not Roman Catholicism. First, it's given to the Orthodox Patriarch of Jerusalem. Secondly, in the years 1969 and 1970, the World Council of Churches put pressure on the Jerusalem Patriarchate to use the new papal calendar, not the Orthodox old calendar. So the Patriarch made the change, but that same year on Great Saturday, the fire did not appear. Patriarch Benedict of Jerusalem, who died in 1981, commanded that the old calendar be restored immediately in his jurisdiction. And the next year, the holy fire did appear with the old calendar. Okay, so if God wanted everyone to be Roman Catholic, if Roman Catholicism is the true church, then why, when the Orthodox Patriarchate of Jerusalem changed the calendar to the papal calendar, did the holy fire not appear? The answer is that God does not recognize this calendar. God does not recognize Roman Catholicism. It seems to me that if Roman Catholicism was the true church and that God endorses the new calendar, not only would the holy fire have appeared at that time, but it seems to me that, you know, it would have been 100 times more brilliant and magnificent than it usually is, because God would want everyone to believe in the new calendar. He would want people to believe in the papacy and Roman Catholicism. But this did not happen. The holy fire did not appear at the time the papal calendar was introduced into the Jerusalem Patriarchate. God does not endorse the papal calendar. He does not endorse Roman Catholicism. This should say something to you if you are a Roman Catholic. You know, it is my opinion that if Roman Catholicism was true and God endorsed Roman Catholicism and the new papal calendar, the holy fire would have appeared and been 100 times more brilliant. That's my opinion. But it seems like God would have given a sign that he endorses the new calendar and Roman Catholicism. But the opposite happened here. The holy fire did not descend when the papal calendar was used. You need to seriously think about this as a Roman Catholic. Okay, the holy fire is given to the Orthodox Christian Patriarch of Jerusalem. I just wanted to share this information. Christ is risen.